Hi everyone, so in this video we will convert our promise based implementation to async await. So from where should we start? From routes, we are clear that we are calling these methods, so we don't need to do anything here. What we need to do is let's start with the user route, user create list and all, and we'll go one by one, and we'll also have to clean this create method using async await. So first of all, list method. Okay, now with the async await, what change you have to do is, first of all, your methods functions will be async. Okay, this is async function. Now you can write await capability here. So you can simply say, I will return the promise being, I will return the promise coming from this method. Okay, and you can wrap this function inside try catch. So if any error comes, because this is a controller, from this place you will be sending a response back. So you can just transform it like this. If any error occurred, then you will be sending 500 error code. For now, we'll write our custom error handlers once this is baselined. Server error. Okay, now what we are doing is user service dot list, and what we are expecting is this should return us the promise, right? Here we can assign this data to some variable const data, and we are using express, so we have to use response to send data back. Okay, this is how it is working, list. Now going there inside a list, it is already returning a promise, so you can also convert this into async await. So we will be waiting until this result is returned. From this, it should be returning a promise. So we can convert all these functions as async await, and now from the controller, things are good. If we got the data, we'll return it. Okay, same wrapper we can assign to other places also. Async get, and here we are doing user service dot find by ID. Find by ID, and I'm passing user ID there. It should return a promise if we get a data. And we are returning it, find by ID return. Okay, so let's convert all these things together and then we will run it. Okay, so we are done. Now from user controller, we'll transform all these methods with the help of try catch. Here we can see if data is null, right? You can throw a user not found, something like this. That is custom exception we can build later. User not found. Now we'll use the try catch block for other methods like create. We are getting request body, and what we are returning is the data response.status. So what we will do is user service.create, we are passing the user which is coming from request.body. That should be enough to do this. We are already handling the catch block. Okay, now user service.create, we are already returning data from there. We are waiting for it, and response.data, this is also converted. and then delete, which is already a straightforward. We are just doing delete user. And we are passing user ID. Okay, this look fine. Now let's see what we are running in the node. Okay, we are getting error here, async list. So in the controller, so we have to actually add a sync function like this, because this is error function. This will come first. Let me fix the other things. Error address already in use, so we cancel this. Okay, now our application is running. We fixed this with async await. There are a few maybe other places where we need to fix this, like in the validator, user validator, find by username. There also we need to validate this. Okay, so this find by username method we are using to check if user already exists or not. So find one will return null if the user not found. So what we can do is, in the validator, this can be async function. Okay, we'll put async here, and we will await for this method to return data. So if we receive data, it means user already exists. So we can actually throw an exception from here, or we can just simply send response.status. or what is that, duplicate exist, we'll send 401 400 for now, bad request dot send error message. We should have something like error message dot, user data invalid or user message taken. Okay, so this is how we can do. I just converted this into async await. Let's see if this works. Now we got getting data. If data we are getting means that user already exists. Otherwise, go to the next middleware. Right. Let's see this now. So we converted these methods from the user service. So we'll try with user service only first. We'll see if we are getting any error. So first we'll convert, create a user. Okay, things are good here. So we can see that data is coming now. So we are able to create user. Similarly, you can get the user. What we did is we just transformed this promise-based implementation to async await, and this is working fine for us, right? So similarly, we can just convert the same implementation for our post routes also, and we will actually fix a lot of issues with this, because now the code looks clean after implementing async await. We know where what error we are handling, when to throw exception, when not to throw exception. Similarly, same thing we will apply on the post controller and we'll push it. Okay, thanks everyone.